A right inverted circular cone has a height of 8 meters and a base radius of 3 meters. How much work does it require to pump all of the water out of the top of the tank if completely full? Enter the exact value. Notice I've already labeled the right inverted cone below, where the height is 8 and the radius is 3. We'll also assume we have the x-axis running along the bottom of the right inverted cone, and the y-axis will run straight through the middle of the inverted cone. And therefore, we can label the point at the bottom of the cone as 0, 0, and the point at the top center of the cone as 0, 8. Recall that work is equal to force times distance, where force equals mass times acceleration, which is equal to density times volume times acceleration. And we will now determine the increment of work it will take to pump out one thin disk of water out the top of the tank. Let's consider this thin disk of water where the radius is r and the thickness or height is delta y. Recall the volume of a right circular cylinder is equal to pi r squared times h. Also notice, analyzing the right side of the cone here, we have two right similar triangles which all enlarge below. Notice for the smaller right triangle, the long leg is y, the short leg is r, and for the larger right triangle, the long leg is 8 and the short leg is 3. Also notice the distance from the thin disk of water to the top of the tank is 8 minus y meters. Because we know the thickness of the disk of water is delta y, our final integral to find the total work will be with respect to y, which indicates we'll have to write the radius r as a function of y, which we can do using the similar right triangles below. Notice y is to 8 as r is to 3, which we can write as a proportion as y divided by 8 equals r divided by 3. And now we solve for r. Cross multiplying, we have 8r equals 3y. Dividing both sides by 8, we have r equals 3/8y, which means the volume of this thin disk of water is equal to, again, pi r squared h, which we can express as pi times the square of 3/8y times delta y. So now we have the volume of the disk of water, and we know the density is 1,000 kilograms per meters cubed for water, and the acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meters per second squared. And finally, the distance this thin disk of water must travel to the top of the tank, which you can see below, is the total height of the tank minus y, or 8 minus y. Which means the increment of work to pump this thin disk of water out the top of the tank is equal to, again, force times distance, which in our case will be density times volume times acceleration times distance, which gives us delta w equals 1,000 times pi times the square of 3/8 y times delta y times 9.8 times 8 minus y. Again, this is simply the density of water times pi times r squared times h times a times distance d. But because we want the total work to pump all the water out of the top of the tank, we want the sum of all the increments of work for every single disk of water, which means we can express the total work as the limit as n approaches infinity of the sum from I equals 1 to n of 1,000 pi times the square of 3/8 y sub I times 9.8 times 8 minus y times delta y sub I. Notice this is the same formula as above, except I just moved the delta y to the right. And this should remind us of the definition of a depth integral. And because the tank is 8 meters high, the total work is equal to the depth integral from 0 to 8 of 1,000 pi times the square of 3/8 y times 9.8 times 8 minus y differential y. And now we simplify and evaluate the integral. Notice 1,000 pi times 9.8 is 9,800 pi, and the square of 3/8 is 9/64. Let's write the integral as 9,800 pi times 9/64 times integral from 0 to 8 of y squared times 8 minus y differential y. Let's go and determine the product outside the integral and also distribute y squared. This gives us a total work equals 11,025 divided by 8 times pi times the integral from 0 to 8 of 8y squared minus y cubed differential y, dy. And now let's evaluate the integral on the next slide. Determining the antiderivative, we have 8 times y cubed divided by 3, or 8/3 y cubed, minus y to the 4th divided by 4, or minus 1/4 y to the fourth. And now we'll determine 11,025 divided by 8 times pi times the difference of big F of 8 and big F of 0. In brackets, we have big F of 8 minus big F of 0. Notice big F of 0 is 0 because both terms contain factors of y. I've already simplified the expression inside the brackets, which is 1,024 divided by 3. And the final product gives us the total work, which is equal to 470,400 pi joules. I hope you found this helpful. Mm-hmm.